Hey guys, I hope you're doing well. What a beautiful weather. Look around. And this place is so good. Okay, so let's talk about the GoPro gimbal. I'm currently recording my video on GoPro with the Fairutech G5 gimbal. So the reason I purchased is when I was in Himachal on the trek, so I had my DSLR, GoPro and a DSLR gimbal. So I was just recording my video with the DSLR and the gimbal. It was just too heavy that I couldn't record it much because I had my backpack, and with the DSLR and the gimbal, it was just too heavy. So I just recording videos with the DSLR handheld, and it was just too shaky. So I tried to do the post stabilization and try to make it look better. And when I was recording video with the GoPro, it was just too shaky that even after applying stabilization, it was not stable at all. And all I needed was wide angle shots, like some walking shots, but I couldn't do it because with gimbal it's just too heavy, and without gimbal it's just too shaky. That's the reason I thought why not to purchase a GoPro gimbal, because it is just too lightweight, so I can carry it everywhere I go. And also this gimbal is waterproof, so the GoPro is waterproof and the gimbal is waterproof, means it's splash proof, so you can use it in the rain. That's why I thought why not to purchase this and use it. It's been few days and I'm liking it a lot, so now I will show you how this gimbal works. So let's see that. Okay guys, so let's talk about this gimbal. First of all, take a look at it, how teeny tiny cute it is. Now once you will just put on the GoPro on this gimbal, just turn it on using this mode button, and that's it. Now you can just start using it and it will just stabilize the video automatically. See, it's so easy. So this is the default mode. Now you can change the angle using the joystick. See that? I'm just pressing down, the camera is going down, and you can rotate as well. I know that it's very slow when you will rotate it, see that? But it works. Now this gimbal has four modes. The first one is the default one, and the second one is the lock mode. Now just press it once and you will go to the lock mode. No matter how much you rotate, it will just stay in the same direction. See, just keep on rotating the gimbal, but the camera will not move. Now the next mode is the pan mode. Just press it twice, one, two, and it will go in the pan mode. So if you will rotate, this will also pan, as you can see that. And the next mode is the selfie mode. So just press it three times, one, two, three, and it will go in the selfie mode. Now they also have one dedicated button. This is the selfie button. Just press and hold it. It will just come to the selfie mode, as you can see that. And now once you will release it, it will go back to the normal mode. Just press and hold it. It will go to selfie and just release it. So I would say that I always use default mode and this selfie mode if I need to record anything. So other than that, I don't use any other mode like lock mode, pan mode. I don't use that because the default mode is good one. So that's pretty much it about the gimbal, and I'm gonna carry it everywhere I go because this is like so handy. And with that said guys, I'll see you next time. Till then, take care, bye bye, whatever you want to do, and keep exploring. Bye bye.